Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is Engine News with the latest updates from the Angular community in 100 seconds every week. TechStackNation runs sessions with members of the Angular team quite often. This time it was Andrew Scott, and the discussion evolved around the removal of Zone.js, which landed in an experimental mode in Angular 18. Zone.js triggers the change detection, which updates the DOM. Andrew told us a little bit about the trade-offs. On the one side, Zone.js does everything for us in terms of change detection and is reliable. On the other side, it could be more performant. Especially signals provide here a very good fit because they can also trigger the change detection, but they also can point it to the right components. A question that comes up very often is,
so should we be using signals for all of our template variables?
Yes.
Andrew also touched a little bit on zoneless testing. We should more use the when stable method of the component fixture and not rely on functions that are Zone.js based, like fake async. Andrew also mentioned a little bit the relationship between the Angular and the TypeScript language server. Other than that, we also got new videos from various content authors. For example, Angular University explaining the signals glitch-free effect and fixed the misunderstanding that toObservable could find a way around it. Dimitro Mechensky, also known as Decoded Frontend, showed how to dynamically add but also remove validators from a form and what kind of pitfalls we have to be aware of. And for those of us who very often run into issues with NPM and have to use force or legacy peer dapps, Francesco Borsi has an alternative that uses the override property in the package JSON. That's it. Wishing you a nice week. See you in the next episode. Goodbye.